Hey guys, welcome to Excel tutorial channel again, and today's chapter we will learn how to count blank and non-blank cells in your worksheet. See, it's a very basic formula, right, with the help of the function of COUNTBLANK function, COUNTA function and COUNTIFs. So we will use these three options, or you can say functions, to resolve this issue. Here at first we will count the number of blanks in our ranges, and second we will count the number of non-blank cells in our ranges, and third we will count the number of blank cells in the specific range with one additional criteria. And what, so here you can see we have this data here with names like Samir, Rahul, Matthews, John, Jane and Kate, right? We have some blank cells also here, right? If we want to, it's just a demo data. If you have a data like with the loads of entries like transactions, or you can say amount, or you can say date, specific name, etc., then you can find easily with the help of count blank function. So in this case, first we're gonna find the number of blanks in our ranges. So the best practice is to name your range, right? If you have some ranges in your cell, two or more, then you should do the named ranges. So we will cover that also in the later stages. So first, if you want to calculate the number of blanks in our ranges, then you can do it simply with the count blank function. So count blank function have only one argument, that is range, and if you have range till Kate like mine, and you just select those ranges, and here you go, we have two number of blank cells in our worksheet. Second will be the number of non-blanks. What you're gonna do is just write count A, and these have the values, value number one, value number two, you have to decide, and you can also select the range here and close it down. Here you got the six. So we have the six valid values here, so it revert back all the number of cells which are non-blank items. So in the next part we will use the criteria based counting of non-blanks. So in this we will take this example here. So these are the quantities sold next to it, 5, 6 and 4, and there are also blank quantity sold values. So if you have a data like this, or you have something sales data or financial data which you want to count on the based of the criteria, in this example we will calculate the non-blank items of the chips here which is not filled in the quantity sold, or you can say which didn't get sold in particular time. So we will use the COUNTIFS function. So let's get around to it. So here I will put COUNTIF, and we have got the criteria range. So criteria range is here, A1 to A2 to A9, and what will be the criteria is, criteria will be chips. So we want to calculate the chips because we need to count only the non-blank items of the chips which is get sold. So here in the next part we will do the criteria range 2. So in the criteria range 2 we will select the quantity sold here, and we will do the blank quotation. So blank quotation, as we also did the AND criteria and OR criteria like in the previous video, where you got to know how to use the AND criteria and OR criteria. So in this example, to counting the non-blank items using the AND criteria. So with the AND criteria, which formula we use, that is the count ifs with the S. So here what we did is we, for in the first criteria range, we select the chips here, okay, and we define the range and we select the chips, and in the second range we will select only the blank items. So with the AND criteria, with the COUNTIFS, it will only select the blank items which is associated with the chips. We have done this part in AND criteria. So if you close it down, and here we got, yes, we got number of one non-blank items which is available with chips. So you can also do the same with biscuits. You can do the same with the biscuits, and if you do that, yes, first, which is here. Hope you got to know how to count blank items and non-blank items in the Excel with simple formulas like count blank or count a function, and also you can do that with the help of COUNTIFs if your working is criteria based. If you like this video, if you have learned something, then please click on the like button, or you can also subscribe to our channel if you want to learn much more about Excel here. See you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.